Welcome back to Adventures in Space. In today's episode, we're diving deep into some of the most exciting advancements we as humans achieved in the aerospace industry. Ever imagined a rocket powered by nuclear fusion? Well, it's not just a sci-fi dream anymore. And as for setting foot on the red planet, NASA's already plotting the course. We're about to explore the future of space travel, from groundbreaking fusion engines to humanity's potential steps on Mars. Subscribe to the channel, and let's blast off. You are watching Adventures in Space. Humanity's pursuit of nuclear propulsion has a fresh player on the scene, Pulsar Fusion. Hailing from the UK, this trailblazing firm is on the path to designing a spacecraft that promises not only a swifter and more secure voyage to Mars, but also envisions a reality where humans could journey as far as Saturn and potentially beyond. From its name, one can deduce that Pulsar Fusion stands among the elite set of pioneers exploring the practicality of nuclear fusion as a means to propel our vessels to farther cosmic realms. Beyond this pioneering venture, the company also delves into other thrust mechanisms, such as their innovative hybrid HDPE motor that harnesses the energy from repurposed plastics. With a focus on clean and efficient motion, it's no surprise that their crown jewel is a nuclear engine. Their digital platform states that the direct fusion drive, DFD, is a refined fusion apparatus capable of delivering both the requisite thrust and electricity to power spaceships. At its core, fusion motors function by compelling atoms to merge, a stark contrast to the traditional fission technique that severs them. This fusion generates heat, subsequently converted into electricity. In Pulsar's design, this energy further ionizes the chosen propellant gas. Encased within a magnetically shielded chamber, drawing parallels with microwave technology, this gas transforms into plasma and is subsequently expelled for propulsion. While this technique mirrors those underpinning present-day ion propulsion systems for profound space exploration, a fusion-triggered mechanism would boost the gas at speeds amplifying up to 1,000-fold. Thus, labeling Pulsar's DFD merely as a fusion-based mechanism might be an understatement. It leans more towards being a magnetoplasma engine. However, the distinction becomes somewhat nuanced given the foundational role of fusion in both. The procedure elevates the plasma to temperatures surpassing several times that of our sun. Yet the genuine puzzle isn't merely achieving this heat, but mastering the unpredictable nature of the heated magnetic plasma. Pulsar's top financial mind, Dr. James Lambert, likens the plasma's behavior to that of a meteorological pattern. Its unpredictable exit from the reaction chamber could compromise the process before thrust initiates. Still, the allure of this engine type lies in its efficiency. While not reaching the peak efficiency of an unadulterated fusion system, the DFD boasts impressive fuel economy. When looking at ISP, specific impulse, which gauges momentum change per fuel unit, Pulsar's DFD stands distinctively efficient compared to engines like SpaceX's Raptor vacuum version, which records an ISP of roughly 380 seconds. The DFD suggests an ISP of 105 seconds, signifying greater efficiency, albeit at a reduced speed. The inherent advantage of this fusion engine is its minimal fuel consumption, permitting continuous burn and prolonged acceleration. While chemical rockets sprint, nuclear and electric engines endure long hauls. Preliminary data from Pulsar hints at their engine potentially slashing Mars travel times by half, making Saturn reachable in 2 years, and allowing a modest 1,000-kilogram vehicle to voyage from Earth to Pluto in a mere 4 years. This implies a monumental expansion in the realms humans can explore. Yet there's a tiny snag. This kind of fusion reaction remains conceptual. In 2022, California's Lawrence Livermore National Laboratory marked a milestone by achieving the inaugural fusion ignition, a process where the generated energy exceeded the initiating laser's input. Film enthusiasts might spot this reactor from J.J. Abrams' Star Trek movies. It was the cinematic backdrop for the Enterprise's warp core. However, this massive apparatus is far too bulky to ever be rocket compatible. Fusion research at Lawrence Livermore has ignited a wave of innovation in the fusion technology realm. The allure of fusion as a sustainable energy alternative is evident, but its potential as a groundbreaking propulsion mechanism is equally captivating. Scientists at Pulsar are leveraging Lawrence Livermore's findings to develop a system compact enough to be integrated into a rocket, even when accounting for the magnetic components essential for plasma control. In collaboration with Princeton Satellite Systems, Pulsar intends to utilize the resources at Princeton Plasma Physics Laboratory in New Jersey to refine their blueprint. Princeton's facility boasts both supercomputers and a reactor suitable for testing. The strategy involves conducting plasma experiments in the reactor to gather essential data. This data will subsequently be processed by Princeton's supercomputers to determine the optimal method for plasma management within a functional rocket. Pulsar's team is optimistic about executing a full-scale rocket trial by 2027. This would entail a traditional booster elevating the fusion prototype to orbit before its engines are ignited. Fusion, being nuclear in nature, does emit a considerable amount of radiation. Yet this mission seems feasible. After all, the fundamental concepts of fusion were understood nearly a century ago, and it wasn't until recent years that they were actualized in a Californian lab. Envisioning this technology incorporated into rockets to expedite space journeys isn't a stretch of imagination. The real test of its viability will be once it's deployed in space. But if preliminary calculations hold true and Pulsar Fusion manages to harness the magnetic turbulence in their engines effectively, this innovation might revolutionize local space expeditions. Now, will this new fusion technology help our Mars missions in the future? Not particularly at this stage of development, but recent remarks from NASA's Jim Free suggest that the agency is now reviewing the mission blueprint for Phase 2 of their Moon to Mars initiative. This involves preparations for manned Mars missions. As the Associate Administrator for Exploration Systems Development, Jim's insights on July 19th addressed NASA's architecture concept review. In essence, NASA will evaluate various campaign proposals before determining mission timelines and collaborating entities. Phase 2 focuses on sending astronauts to Mars, making this scrutiny even more riveting than Phase 1, which unveiled a slew of new rockets, landers, satellites, rovers, and habitat designs post the announcement of the Artemis missions. Therefore, by November, when this evaluation kicks off, expect a plethora of cutting-edge systems and crafts up for discussion. Yet, refining the myriad of proposals down to a select group is equally captivating. NASA must have a clear vision of their targets before selection. This entails connecting mission goals to particular missions and providing design guidelines to their collaborators. In fact, at the aforementioned July 19th symposium, Jim revealed that the first five missions already have specified major objectives. Feedback on the preliminary mission outlines was sought from partners as early as June during workshops and sessions. Jim highlighted the exceptional contributions from these affiliate bodies. But what do you guys think? Will NASA eventually use nuclear fusion in its plans to send humans to Mars, or fusion will remain a sci-fi fantasy? Drop all your theories in the comment section down below. Come back here for more updates on everything space exploration related and much more. As always, this was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you in the next one.